testing the difference between two means with independent samples. For example, do the students in an accelerated program at a local high school have higher scores on the math portion of the SAT than their comrades? To test this claim, 100 students in the accelerated program and 100 students in the traditional program were sampled at the local high school. After taking the SAT, the students in the accelerated program had an average score of 590 with a standard deviation of 50, and the students in the traditional program had an average of 520 with a standard deviation of 75 for the math portion of the test. Perform a test at the 1% level of significance. To test this claim, we are going to perform a test at the 1% level of significance. For this example, we are comparing two means whose samples are independent. Students in the traditional program are different from the students in the accelerated program. Thus, we have independent samples. So our first step is to identify the hypotheses. For the null hypothesis, we'll have mu1 is equal to mu2. Here, we are assuming that there is no difference between the two groups. For the alternative hypothesis, we're going to test that mu1 is greater than mu2. We're using greater than because we want to know if students in the accelerated program at a local high school have higher scores on the math portion of the SAT than their comrades. So we're going to make group 1 the accelerated students. And group 2 will be the traditional students. For the second step, we are going to identify the level of significance. And here, alpha is equal to 0.01. For the third step, we are going to compute the test statistic. Using the values from the scenario, make note of the sample mean and sample standard deviation for each group. Recall, the accelerated students are in group 1, and the traditional students are in group 2. Be careful not to confuse the two groups. Therefore, the sample mean and standard deviation for group 1 is 590 and 50, respectively, and the sample mean and standard deviation for group 2 is 520 and 75, respectively. Because we assume that there is no difference between the two groups, mu1 minus mu2 will always equal 0. So for our test statistic, we have the following formula. Once we plug in the values from the scenario, we obtain the following. And for mu1 minus mu2, because there is no difference, that will be 0. After computing the math, we obtain a test statistic of 7.77. For step 4, we're going to determine the critical value. And since this test follows a t-distribution, we're going to use the t-table. But first, we're just going to draw this out so we can determine the rejection region. And so once we draw this out, you'll notice that we'll have area on the right tail of the distribution because we have a right-tailed test. So we're going to shade to the right of this critical value and note that alpha is equal to 0.01. Since we're using the t distribution, we also have degrees of freedom. And our degrees of freedom for this test is the smaller of n1 minus 1 or N2 minus 1. Since both of the sample sizes were the same, we can determine that our degrees of freedom are 99. And so looking at the t-table and locating 99 degrees of freedom, we determine that our critical value is 2.33. Our test statistic of 7.77 falls in the rejection region. It's way out here. And so we're able to reject the null hypothesis. For step 5, we can state our decision and our conclusion. So since we're able to reject the null hypothesis, we can state that there is sufficient evidence to suggest that the students in an accelerated program at a local high school have higher scores on the math portion of the SAT than their comrades.